In this video I want to show and explain about restoring old timber framed or half timbered houses as you can find them in southern Germany. In the Middle Ages one typically did timber framing by using lap joints for the diagonal parts, braces, which had to keep the rectangular frames stable. This lap joint method is associated with the term Upper German or Alemannic timber frame. It was used until 1500 when new and better methods were introduced, as the timber frame with mortise and tenon joints. But the old-fashioned Alemannic timber frame still can be found, as this 600-year-old example in Ulm, but also in Esslingen and other cities. The standardized construction of these houses led to relatively small variations in their shape, so this drawing shows the standard model of the medieval Alemannic house.
So, das ist jetzt ein Holzmodell von dem Haus, jedenfalls andeutungsweise. Die Anblattungen sind hier nicht eingelassen, aber es ist eine gute Andeutung von der Grundstruktur des Hauses. Man sieht schon schön, wie jedes Stockwerk für sich getrennt abgezimmert ist. Das ist also eine Rahmenkonstruktion und keine Firstständer oder sowas Bauweise. Diese Räume und die da drüben liegenden Schwellen klemmen dann jeweils den Stockwerkboden ein. Die Besonderheit dieser Häuser liegt unter anderem in dieser Halbwallenausbreitung hier oben, die da oben drin noch ein Rauchloch frei ließ. Das Rauchloch selber war dafür da, weil der gesamte Dachraum, wenn man noch mit dem Rauch, Kamine kannte man noch nicht, aus den Feuerstellen des Hauses eben voll war und hier oben dann raus konnte.
The typical elements of this timber frame structure are the horizontal sole plate or Schwelle, the vertical post or Ständer, and above the top plate or Rahmen. Then the braces with their lap joints. They are held in place by wooden pegs. Also horizontal are the sill plates, which have mortise and tenon joints in the post. The wall is filled with vertical stakes that fit in small holes. Then tracery is put in, covered with mud. In our house we have to restore many missing parts of the original timber frame, for example here the ram or top plate, which is missing on two-thirds of its length. Careful measuring is necessary to ensure that the new beam would fit exactly under the still existing floor joists that once rested on it. Then different sorts of indentations had to be made for the original joists as well as for additional beams that were inserted into the ceiling while enlarging the house in the 18th century. But also for the lap joints, not to forget the holes for the stakes and the mortise for the new post. In the end, the beam looked very much like a rack. We brought it up as usual, with a hydraulic jack, some props and physical strength. Some last fine-tuning with the chainsaw and it fitted snugly in all joists. Except that in the corner. Here is a gap of about 1 cm. But that could be closed easily by the force of 8 metric tons. Here I have drilled imitations of the holes for the stakes, but as the wall will be left open, this is only to demonstrate the original situation. One frame above, there is an identical situation with an original top plate. Above you can see how the filling of the frame was made. Now a new post had to be made. Here the tenon on the top is cut. On the side I made a mortise for the new sill plate, and on the other side as well, even if there will be no reconstruction of the wall. Here the braces are made using the chainsaw for rough cut and a plane for smoothing it. The wood for the braces is hardwood and it is cut from logs with small diameters, 18 to 25 centimeters, using as much as possible from the natural shape of it. so that the grain is mostly parallel to the outline. Here the brace is marked where it will get its lap joint with the post. Then the brace is cut in the right shape. The part of the lap joint itself has to be thinner than the brace, giving her a shoulder that can rest against the side of the post. A slight curve on the side makes the lap joint dovetailed and prevents it from gliding out. Then the new sole plate was put in its place. It's now only half as thick as it once was due to the higher level of the new floor. Inserting the post was tricky. From the sole plate I had to cut away two wedge-like parts. Then these parts were glued on again, taking the tenon in between them. The brace is now put in its place. The slot for the joint is marked and then chiseled out. The chainsaw is again a very useful tool to speed things up. If you are wondering why the lap joint is going all the way across the post, not leaving space for another brace at the left side, we found out that there was no brace, but a larger window or a door. Last thing was to drill a hole and fix the brace on the post with a wooden peg. Same thing for the lap joints and the top plate. This had to be done from behind because of this parallel steel beam that I couldn't take out at that moment. Now everything is in place, the bricks are filled in, and the new old wall is almost finished.